you know, I hate to stop the music just like that, but it's been cray cray around here today. Hey, happy Veterans Day, and thank you for your service for all our veterans and their families. You know, I can't talk about that too much without tearing up. I don't know why. I'm just a little sentimental and patriotic that way. So, of course, I got my Mickey Mouse t-shirt on. Hey, this is Ann Clemmer and Stamper from stamperdoc.com. Thank you for waiting. Let's get started.
Stamper, come.
Oh, you know, I love Stamp Club, but you know, tomorrow, the next morning, like today, comes really quick. Hey, let's see who we got here. Hold on one second. Oh, I did not refresh this. Thank you. Oh, you know, you make time for me, I make time for you, but you know, sometimes I run on Clemmer time, and it's really not Clemmer time because my husband is early to everything, kind of like my dad was, you know, I mean, so, hey, who's your favorite vet? You know, who is it that you know? No, I just went and stopped the wrong thing here. Hold on one second. We're getting there. We're getting there. You're here. Yay. Yeah, well, here's the thing. I need you to help me make him a Veterans Day card, and I'm going to show you an easy way to do it and another easy way to do it that's really more, you know, just a little bit more advanced, but it's still just as easy because, you know, Fast and Fabulous is our middle name. Oh, Kim's son. Okay. Well, how about this? Our granddaughter yesterday joined the Army Reserves. Yeah, she's already got a 4-year degree, so I'm thinking she's going to start out as an officer. You would think that. I've forgotten more than I ever knew, right? My husband did 22 years, and he married. I met him at McCord. It's now, my daughter calls it by its initials now. It's like Joint Base Fort Lewis McCord, and Fort Lewis is huge. That's an Army post there, and then it joined in when with McCord, which is the Air Force Base, which yeah. you know, that happened when I wasn't looking. So yeah, it was, oh golly, Nancy's dad and his son. Okay. Hold on one second. Is that better? Is that better? Of course, remember to look on your phone too, because I went and I was messing with this last night, and who knows, you know, what could have gotten changed. I was thinking I had it too loud. And so, yeah, it's hard for me to test it at night, which is when I usually do my technical stuff, because I'm trying to be kind of quiet, right? So, you know, okay, so you got to answer me. You got to tell me, because it's, you know, yeah, I'm just looking at little things here saying... saying, you know, if I don't want it to go into the yellow and the red, because then that really would be bad. But hold on, I can fix it. I don't want to keep fixing it and then I'm beyond good. So, hey, I'll show you how you can. Oh, very good. Okay. Well, that was an easy fix, but let me go save it now. So that while I. There. While I have it right. We had Stamp Club last night, and if you were on the dog's blog today, you would see where I, oh golly, some of these are, have moved or fallen off. That has to do with it's, you're not looking, that's okay. Oh golly, Marcy's got a lot of military. Okay, need it. Just don't turn it off, okay? Okay, what is... okay, got it. So anyway, this is how we finished off that box the other day, right? Now, see, and this is the card that they're going to make, except for I think they used more than what I had set out of these, and I'm not getting any more of these in. So, yeah, I may be in trouble, but see the thing with this. Oh, see, I guess one. Oh, here it is. And I did this, and I couldn't believe I took a picture of it. Now they're. My finger's healing. It's. I just don't want you to look at it. I think only because this is, oh, what do you call it? You know, at different levels. Only because that's at different levels, I'm thinking that's why it has a hard time. But this was so easy. You just put it on and then color the rhinestones. Now, I'm going to share something with you. When you're coloring rhinestones, you know, and I love everybody, so... And you know, I gave them one where the tip had been compromised when I gave it to them before, right? And you know, these things are meant to be used in love. But when you're coloring rhinestones, this is what happens when you go and push, and you go and push too hard, right? And this is a. This is how they look if you lightly color them, right? But if you push on it, you're going to make your tip go like that, and there's still a lot of ink in there, but you're not going to be happy. So, because it wasn't like that when I gave it to my lovely friends. And, you know, you don't know which one's doing it. All I know is that somebody said, oh, golly, this is, you know, and if it's not getting enough color, then go to a darker color, which I wasn't going to do because I knew I was what they were doing to these, right? Oh, golly, Deb. Yeah, there you go. Oh, I faced Mickey the wrong way. He's now on his head. Oh, I wasn't looking. Oh, boy, my nose. You can replace the tip. They don't sell tips. Oh, I'm almost afraid to ask you what to, you know, what do I bind up dog hair and put it in there? So, hey, this is what I made for all of you. You know, I haven't put it on the... I put it on the dog's blog, but I haven't put it on Facebook and stuff yet, but I will as soon as I get off. I think we're going to go to an early dinner today. Well, Beverly Marcy says that you can replace the tip. And, you know, it's just, you know, sometimes, you know, you have to pick your battles. Yeah, and that, you have to pick your battles with your supplies, too. And like... with your dog, you have to pick your battles. And so for me, I just, I'll just go buy a new one. In fact, I already have. Okay. I already have, because the first time I gave it to him, it was compromised. But it was the second time I gave it to him that happened. And there was only three of them last night, but you can see how many rhinestones they colored. Whoa. I mean, they colored a lot of rhinestones, like 3 dozen, but still it shouldn't have been that bad. And I think somebody wasn't getting enough color, and I gave them a light cherry cobbler. So those are, both of these are light cherry cobbler. And believe me, I wouldn't even sell it to you on the garage sale. So yeah. And so let's talk about a card. Oh. Okay, we're gonna start off with the drink. Now, I don't know about you, but I like to take my favorite veteran to lunch on Veterans Day, and we usually go to someplace like Applebee's, right? Because they were the first ones to do it, and we don't go there very often. But then there was a spot, I should find that link, where they listed all the places, all the national franchises that are doing things today. And one of them is Red Robin, where if you're in their, like, frequent flyers club, they will go and they'll give you a gift certificate, or, you know, load it into your account if you're a veteran, so that you can have a free certain kind of burger between tomorrow and the end of the month, which I thought that was pretty smart. So anyway, hey, we're going to start off with real, real, real red. Yay. Woo. There you go. And by the way, yes, he's here. Oh, and there's my foot. I think that this moved a little bit, Stamper. Yeah, Kay, I'm going to be calling you because I have a question about him. I think his tummy's upset. So back to the matters at hand. He jarred his head like... He jarred his head like, are you telling them my personal business? Okay. Hey, Deb Bradford. Yeah. I think I just Googled Veterans Day food, right? Yeah. Or something like that. So back to this. I've got that. I got this partially ready last night, and then I didn't make the card. So yeah. But if you can do this, cut them out all at the same time, right? If you have like a guillotine color, hey, I'll send up a quick prayer for Beverly that she gets through that. And I chose very vanilla because, you know, it's kind of like that old, you know, the old Americana, right? And then here we've got, this is not quite, no, this is a Knight of Navy. Hello. And then, okay. Now that's dedication. Okay, and then this is real red, right? But you could do a cherry cobbler would be nice with this. And I didn't look at it, but cherry cobbler, what's the other one? Tell me. Midnight. Okay, what is it, everybody? Golly. Misty Moonlight. Oh, golly. So, you know, and that might be, that's flatter. So, you know, I mean, go find the one, but this one will work with white or very vanilla. You know, it'll do with either one. And I cut these, they're a quarter of an inch smaller. Now you can choose which one you want, but for me, I like to have navy on the top because I didn't cut that a little bit smaller there. Hold on. I like to have navy on the top because navy is, that's where the, hold on one second. That's where the stars are. Okay. You know, why did I do that? That is so funny. Why did I do that? Because I'm going to be cutting it off anyway. Yeah, Misty Moonlight. Okay, so I'm going to do this. Now, this is, you know, this is really not the way I'm going to put the card together. It's just to let you know so that you can do it, right? And I started to pick up the keyboard once again because I thought it was the... Because I thought it was the trimmer. I mean, they're right next to each other and it's dark. It's dark in here. So here, we're gonna take this, and because we're gonna put the navy on the top, what I'm going to do is, and you don't have to pay attention to, oh golly, it's gonna do that thing where it doesn't like that. Let's try to go out farther. I'm just saying pay attention to the numbers. So like I'm gonna put this with the one, this corner on the one, and this corner I'm gonna put right up to the, what is that, 2.5 line, right? And then I'm going to sit down, cut it. But of course it shifted a little bit when I did that. So yeah, so there's that. And now here at the bottom, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to put the corner on the one. Hold on. Actually, I'm going to shift it up to two, and I'm going to put it a little bit that way only because, like 2 1/16, only because it shifted when I moved it. I didn't. And then this, I'm going to put it. Look, did I say 2.5? Let's see, hold on. 1, 2.5, right? So you would think if I put this on the 2 or just above it, because that's, you know, I had an issue, and then this is gonna cut it. Let's see how that works. Mathematically, physics, it should, right? It should. So there's that. And there's that. And now you've got your card. So now if you were wondering, well, how did they get those even? These weren't cut at the same time. See, there you go. And then, hold on. Here are some stars I cut out. It came out of something I'm going to be putting. There you go. Oops. This is just a simple card that you can do. And of course, hold on. Now you could put this on a blue background, or you could put it on a red background. It's whatever floats your boat. As you know, he likes blue. I like red. It's a winner with both, right? And then you could cut out a star, put it here. You could stamp here. You could. I got a lot of different options here. Here's one, massive thanks. This is a great one to have, right? This is 1, 5, 2, 5, 7, 8. And this, and then I would put it like on a white banner. I wouldn't leave it like that. Very vanilla, just a little banner coming out this way. And texturing would add a lot to it. So this is like the basic premise. Right? There's also, I'll put that there so you can see that. Here's another one, Peaceful Moments. Oh, see, look at that. That you could put down on a, hello. This might, you know what? If I did this one, I would most likely go and, if I did this one, I would make a thin strip and I would lay it on top here and go all the way across. So, yeah. It's a lot of things that you can do, but we're going to kick it up from here. Hold on. Here's another thanks. this has, if you're just starting out, this has a lot of things. You know, it's got stuff for a sympathy card. You know, you made my day. I made you a card because you're worth it. Wouldn't that be right? Like right there. And, you know, you could stamp stars along here. You know, it's, you just kind of work with it. I'm giving you the basic premise of that's the basic premise. And I'm going to show you where I got these from. Some of these are not good for this, but you know, you could just put, thanks is not normally, you know, to me, it's not as impactful for a card like this. I would use thank you, you know, more than thanks, but thanks is normally pretty. And here's another really thin thank you if you've got the Boho Indigo set where you could just put a long strip. Yeah. Yeah, always remember. And then here's another one that has a lot of different ones. This, I think, would be great because that includes not just what they did now then, but what they're doing now, right? So anyway, yeah, you could put, that would fit right in there. Or maybe cut it a little bit. But if I did this, I would definitely texture that. So let's move along to the beautiful part. And you'll see where I came up with the rest of it. I'm glad the dog moved because the stamps fell. For this, okay, I learned something with this one. This is what it, the curvy, this is the special that's up now. There you go. Curvy Celebrations. It's great because it's got a lot of stuff. I find myself using this hilly one a lot. This one. I find myself using this one, but what I want you to realize is the cutting edge is only on one side, and more than once, hold on. More than once I have gone to cut it and it cuts the wrong side. Yeah. See, now here's the Christmas one that goes with it. I could have used that last night because we did a Minnie Mouse card. And I didn't make it because I only had enough design series paper for them. And yeah. Oh, here it is. Here it is. Here it is. There we go. So yeah, when I was cutting this, I went and I, okay. Yeah, that's not the what I. So here we've got that. Now look at, isn't that like, whoa, cool. And there's nothing saying that you can't have. Wow. I don't know what I cut this part for. Yeah, at this point, it kind of got jumbled up. There we go. It could be like this. You can do it any way you want to. But isn't that nice for a wave? Now, they have other waves. So you could do this, maybe if you were doing this for a lady, that would be, you know, but remember it cuts on this side and goes up in. So, you know, and when I go in, yeah, I could do that, but I'm not. you could put a fabric sheet in there to help pick up the stuff, but I'm always concerned about, you know, when you, the more stuff you put in there, then you have to realize that the gears on your machine are fixed to cut a little sheet of paper to some foil to maybe a thick item, but not real thick. But then when you start putting more and more stuff in there, then you've got to be compromising your gears. Because I've had three big shots. Yeah, that old one. And I only broke one. I'm pretty careful with stuff, just like furniture. My furniture can last for like ever because I don't sit on the arms. And I about have to go, when I see somebody do that, I'm going, yeah, you know your couch isn't going to last as long, right? So, yeah, you could use this too. I'm thinking of using it for my bangs. What do you think? So, hey, if you have the stars, and you should get them because it's a staple. It works for Christmas. It works for patriotic cards. And so, yeah. And look at this is where I got. That's where I got these little stars here. So, of course, if I did that. This is not how I remembered it. I've slept since then. I think, you know, and if I want to make this shorter. Well, I could do that. Yeah. I have friends that. No, that's just the same thing. See, I would really like to see it like this. I think that works for me. That works. But, oh, yeah, what I was going to tell you, when you go in and throw these through here, try to turn the paper so that you're going this way and not that way, right? The other thing is that I've been using the pokey tools, not the pokey, the pick. Take your pick tool, the brush end. This has worked really well to just go like this, and I just do it over the, yeah. The other thing about using a fabric sheet, you know, a fabric softener sheet, it's a good idea. I'm not saying it's not a good idea, but the other thing about doing a fabric softener sheet is, what if you are giving it to someone who is, you know, maybe scents bother them? And even if you've gotten an unscented one, you know, you just don't know. And so I always, just the same thing with wearing your mask these days. You know, if it's not a thing, if it doesn't help at all, well, at least I've erred on the cautious side, right? Think about that. Let's see. Oh, hey, okay. I'm not going to tell your secret, Nita. Only people over there on Facebook know. So I'm going to cut. What do you think? I'm going to cut. What's that? An inch and a half? Oh, golly. It is exactly an inch and a half. Yeah, even though that says score, that just tells me that the top one is score. Yep, there you go. There you go, Laura. So for those of you who didn't check out the dog's garage sale yesterday after I posted that shirt, the shirt's already gone. Yeah. There you go. But you could, okay, I'm going to tell you a secret now. You could find it at Target. It's actually $2 cheaper now, but you have to spend at least $35 for them to ship it to you. They don't have it in the stores. They do have it in the women's sizes and the women's plus sizes. Now, I'm going to tell you, the women's plus sizes are just about right. But the women's sizes, that might be the one where the lady said it was very small. Or maybe she just got a bad one. It's hard when only one or two people comment. So when you get buy something and you get a good thing, make sure you post it. Because I don't know about you, but I look at the reviews on things. And when sometimes people are posting on the wrong item. And here you might not buy something thinking, yeah. So anyway, yeah, there you go. So which way should we put this together? I know what I want to do. Golly, where am I at here? I'm going to go just go to that because I'm going to go and put a little bit of texture on this because I think that's going to make it be really pretty. And I'm going to usually I layer them and then put them through, but this time I'm going to just go put them through. Get my sandwich right. Now remember, if you are going to take your favorite vet out to eat, I would definitely go and do it before the rush, if you can. Or you know what? There's nothing wrong with taking them out tomorrow and paying full price. It's just something that we started doing when my husband when he worked at Target. Okay, just one more. Yeah, this is something else I learned last night. You know, I think we talked about this a long time ago. Oh, I might have put this through going the wrong way. We'll see. I hope not. We learned this a long time ago, but if you have old dyes, no, that looks about right. Well, if you have old dyes, I put an O on these because when you put them through your die cutting machine, hopefully the cut and emboss machine, you don't have to have that special plate for it. So I'm going to get out my glue. Get ready because you guys are going to have to make a decision for me. And I'll do it quickly so that. Oh, Ann Clemmer. Okay, learn from my mistakes. Make sure that you've got the right size paper. It's this one I should have done. That's okay. I can do that really quick. Now I forgot what I was going to tell. Yeah, I told you about putting put an O on these old ones so that you know. Yeah, I want to pick it up. Connie says she's going to pick hers up, and that's what we normally do. But I don't know how they're going to go and handle the veteran stuff, you know, because we're happy with sitting at home. I mean, that, you know what, I gotta tell you, I have never done that before. I have never done this before. But you are my peeps. This is the Suttles folder, and I love it. You can go this way, and then if you go put it through again this way, then it really looks like linen. It's a really a must-have. Okay, so I have another half sheet. I have all this cut paper here. And now you know why I don't always put these together. Do you know what? I have to tell you, you really need to not beat yourself up when you make a mistake. You know, I mean, life is too short. This is, you know, life is too short. Come on. And I take orders from a dog. So it's just, yeah. Okay. So this time I'm going to double check before I put it on. And I hope, I did put it on right. And I always use glue when I do these because, and those of you who don't like glue, just stretch it on. Boy, I almost had an accident there. I even put, that's even a little bit too much. Just wider but thinner pieces, right? I match up three sides. But you want to get it close to the edge only because when you put it on, but not too close, so that the sides will lay down, especially with something like this that has been, that has so much texture in it, it's going to want to lift. Okay, so now this, see, and when you do this, this weakens this, so you don't want to go in, necessarily put it on, you don't want to necessarily go and put it on dimensionals, because it's weakened, and it's, then when you send it and see, look at, here's a secret. If this is a little bit off down below, see, it looks even to me, but I can see in the, if it's off, if this was off, I could straighten it up a little bit here by pushing this one up a little bit there. We'll try that. We'll say it worked. Do, 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 do. Yeah. Okay, now were there any thoughts that I didn't finish because I got distracted? Holly, thank you for coming. If I've seen your name, it hasn't been a lot. Yeah. New peeps, yay! If you haven't shared this yet, you know, why not? You know, yeah. Share the love. Now, the reason why I put everything through together, see, now this one I purposely did not want it to necessarily match, is because when you put it through all this texturing, all this up and down and up and down, right? It has to, you know, that geography has to come, that real estate has to come from somewhere, right? And so if you go and do all of them, and usually I would put them all through together. You got that right, Kathy. Yep. Then it will do them all at the same time. And I could have done that, and I frequently do, but every now and then I try something different. Okay, so here we're going to get to, look at this. This is from the stars. Now, in a perfect world, I would have gone and put this with the adhesive, you know, the adhesive sheets. But see, look at, now you wonder where these came from. Those came out of this. So I have for two cards, but I only did one, right? There was more than that. They're here somewhere. Maybe they're in Stamper's Dream here. But there was more than that. Not much more. But a lot has happened since then. Right, that's what I'm talking about. Putting these two together and then running them through all at the same time. If you do it that way, don't use glue. You could just use seal. You can just use your regular, like this, right? You can just use that because it's going to be pressing them together. But when you're this, you know, when you're putting together textured things, and by the way, this doesn't, whoa, it shows a little bit over here, but I think it's a little bit too late to. I was talking and chewing gum at the same time. Let's see if I can push that. No, that's okay. That's what they have markers for. Did I see one? Here's a little spot. But yeah, this brush is great to have. And it comes with the foam bases. And then it's really easy to just go. But because I pushed these out, I didn't have any marks on these. Now, the only thing is trimming it before you put it on, then you really need a guillotine cutter for that. And because it's not going to work with the, it's going to be hard to cut it with a trimmer. Just so you all know. Now, I know we have that fine tip glue, but I'm not a fan. In fact, somebody just bought one. She couldn't even get the top off. Oh, no, that's what it was. So she contacted me and said, I bought this, you know, and I told her I'm not a fan. And so then she tells me, she goes, I can't even get the glue to come out. And so I asked. And by the way, you can do this with a toothpick. Anyway, I asked, I said, did you take the protective covering off the bottle? I'm just psychic. Because who hasn't done that before? We've all done it. Now, where this is going to be hard, like these thin ones, yeah, this is definitely, that's about as good as it's going to get. I think I want it to go around this way. Because this barely fits. There you go. Anne is wonderful. Anne is wonderful. Anne is wonderful. Thank you. Hey, whatever works. So there you go. Okay, we got it that far. And see, I can still put some of these here. And I had thought about, you know, we have what would have been nice. Okay, and you put the stamp set down where? There it is. What would have been nice, but I'm not going to do it now because it's already textured. Yeah, you know, I'm just going to call a spade, and that's it. You know, I mean, it's not that it's a bad thing. It's just that... Yeah. See, look at the because of the way these are. This I'm looking at it upside down. Maybe it would be. See, look at this would have been nice in blue right across there. But you know what? I think I like that. This will just have to be the way it is because after this, yeah, yeah. The thing about the glue, it tends to. I don't know. It just still tends to clog up and then you don't use it all. And then, you know, you try the pin and it, I'd rather just go and take this glue, which works really well. And I believe it's stronger than the other, the fine tip glue and apply it with a toothpick. Yeah. Just don't use the toothpick in your teeth afterwards. So do you like that? Like that? I mean, we have other ones, you know, we could do the massive thank you, but I like the size of this. If I went for a smaller thank you, then I would probably, but because of who it's for, I'm probably going to just do that and I'll just do it on a strip of, well, you know, you could do it. How about I could do it on vellum and, emboss it in gold. Yeah. And then just put a little, you know, the tail here. Yeah. But I just kind of like that layout. And, you know, if I used a smaller greeting, then I would probably put more of these on. But it really only needs three. Yeah. So there you go. I hope you like that. I hope he likes that because we have to finish it before we go eat, right? He's out there. He can't see it. He can hear me talking about it. Yeah, but you know how guys are. They're really not listening to everything all the time. Hey, I just want to thank you for those of you who have been shopping with us and supporting us and hanging out with us. You know, this has just been a great thing. We've been doing it. I think this is the third year. And now just this month, it's Master Stamper is 9 years old. And we have hundreds of projects over there. And we are going to be ending our try it out for a month and you try it, you get the first 2 months for the price of one and it is awesome. And just in case you were wondering, sound is fine. But I'm going to write that down here. Where you're going to have to go while the opportunity is available. Hello. I'm looking. Whoa. So, yeah, I like this. I will tell him hello. Oh, see, there's one of those stars. There's one of those stars. So if you're thinking that you want to try Master Stamper out, all you have to do is go to stamperdog.com and then just / master me. Yeah. And you could try it out because we've got 325 projects. That's the ones that are numbered. There's more on top of that. And there's a lot of people who are here on the call with us that are already in it. And they're going, wait a minute, don't I get a free month too? Well, you know, I'm going to figure out something nice for them. But yeah, go to stamperdog.com/mastermy. And that, you know, you can be in on it. It's not a veterans thing. We've been doing this for a couple months now between Stamper's birthday and... Now it is Master Stamper is 9 years old, and so we're going to be closing it soon, and you would don't want to miss out. So try it out. We would love to have you, and we also have if you don't have any more time, just use the website. If you have if you want more social interaction with it, then use the Facebook part of it, you know, because then you can post your own stuff and share it. It's just great. We've kind of made it for everyone, and we would love to have you part of that, everyone. Hey, this is Ann Clemmer. I've just been blessed by you today, and I want you to go bless someone today and go send them a card or put some cookies on a veteran's doorstep and run away, but put a card with it too, right? Saying thank you for your service. I want to thank you for spending some time with us. I'm here with Stamper from stamperdog.com, where we try to put a little ink, paper, and fun
yes
into your day.